Hello, we're up here in the Bighorn Mountains again. Been spending a lot of time here in my time in Montana, and just a beautiful area. And this is incredible. This is, scenes like this are exactly why I like to come out west. It's an absolutely gorgeous day. There's some clouds, but there's no clouds behind me or to block out the light of the scene that I want to paint here. So, couldn't ask for a better scenario. Just going to roughly sketch out the shape of the mountains. These mountains are just towering above me. I think I'm going to change the shape a little bit and bring these peaks up. And these be lower back. By the way, if you're new to my channel, or if you've been watching for a while and you haven't done so yet, if you could do me a favor and hit the subscribe button. That helps encourage me to continue making these videos and lugging my camera equipment up in the mountains. I was almost just going to record or do this one without recording it, but I thought, heck, let's bring you guys along. This is just so incredible. So I'm just thinking of my overall structure and composition. I like how these mountains kind of meet down here in this valley area. So that's the main thing I want to capture. This is just to give me an idea of where this is going. A little breezy up here, but it's absolutely beautiful. Actually, the breeze helps because it's a little warm for up here in the mountains. So I want to block in these darks first. I can see I'm going to need more viridian, but I want to get the darks blocked in because they're going to help me gauge all the other values. Get some more viridian. If By the way, the colors on my palette, titanium white, cadmium lemon, cadmium yellow light, cadmium orange, yellow ochre, transparent red oxide, cadmium red, alizarin crimson, ultramarine blue, cobalt blue, cerulean, viridian, and chromium green oxide. Want to get in some of these greens in the foreground. I like to get these greens and foreground colors in early because you could see it's already starting to take shape. Getting these yellows in early is really helping to push all this back. I painted mountains enough times where I know that if I don't get these foreground elements in, what I'll start doing is I'll start painting all kinds of ambiguous grays back here instead of the stronger blues that you see when you compare this with this. Need some more cadmium yellow light. What I really need is a painting caddy. Oh, I can't remember if I mentioned over here, I also have Gamlin's Portland Gray Light. And I really like that color when I come out west. It does a great job of giving you almost instant depth and atmosphere. And it does a nice job also at mimicking the colors of the light side of distant mountains. So when I squint at this scene, these trees back here are a little darker. Than the foreground trees, or the foreground bushes, I should say, and shrubs. Just gonna get those in. There's also some rocks in the foreground. Might try to get those in too, but my primary concern are those mountains. So that's what I'm going to go after. Just a fair warning, I might not talk a whole lot in this video. This is a pretty intense scene for me. Partly because I'm so in love with it. Keeping all this very thin right now. If you're wondering what the background noise is, it's actually a river. I'm in a fairly secluded area. There are some houses around, but not many. This is a bear territory too, so I gotta kinda watch it. I did bring my bear spray along with me. The primary objective of, really for me, any landscape painting, but especially one like this, is to capture the aerial perspective, the correct colors and values that are going to give me the aerial perspective. And what that is aerial perspective. I talk about this a lot in my videos. I also talk about it in my live online classes, which I offer. There's a link below if you're interested. But aerial perspective is basically where you set up your colors and values to show depth and distance in your painting. And it's really, you know, how things are in nature too. So if you're painting aerial perspective, you're just painting nature as it is. Now the shadows on these rocks here, They get a little darker, a little warmer as they come toward you. That's aerial perspective. So I'm going to use a little more red in my blue to show that. Now, I'm not going to get these mountains exactly as they are, and I don't need to. That's what a camera's for. Also, I could do a nice little pencil sketch of them later, which I might do. Precise shapes are not what I'm after. It's capturing the colors and values. That's what I need in this. Okay, testing out the Portland Gray Warm. It's amazing, I guess they made this based on the sky conditions that are commonly known in Portland, but it works so well for these mountains. Need to tone it down with some Viridian. And of course I have some white in there too. Really trying to squint at this scene as I look at it. Get this white covered up here. If you're interested in supporting my channel, I have a Patreon account where you can sign up and contribute. Right now it's anywhere from $3 up. So if you're interested, go check it out. And I thank you very much if you do. Okay, so big thing I gotta get in is the relationships between this and this and now the sky. Now there are some beautiful clouds in that sky. I might make some room for them, but there's also a lot of areas where there isn't clouds. Oops, I got some of the mountain color in. Okay, so at this point, your main objective should be to look at this and just ask yourself, does this feel further away than this? And does this feel further away than that? And does this feel further away than that? And does the sky feel further away than all this stuff? And that's the big thing. Now, this back here is very interesting. I think I need to manipulated a bit. It's even though it doesn't look this cool, I think I'm gonna have to cool it down just a bit more to push it back there to exaggerate it. Yeah, that might be a little too much. So I'm going to go in with a bit of the Portland gray warm. Just knock that down a bit. So this area right here, it looks like it's got just a touch of green in it, but I'm going to use Viridian. In fact, it does have green. What I'm seeing here as I look at this is not really shadow. It's trees, but they're so far away that they look like shadow. I certainly hope the sounds of nature and my maybe occasional heavy breathing, I hope I'm not breathing heavy, but I tend to do that when I get up in these alpine areas. But I hope they're sufficient to make up for my lack of talking. As I said, when I get focused on something like this, I don't talk a whole lot. Sorry, I just got flies around me. And I'm just constantly comparing every tone I put down. I'm comparing it to, you know, what's next to it. And just asking myself, you know, does that serve the effect of aerial perspective? The effect of these being further away than these mountains here. If I get that, I'm home free. If I don't, this whole thing was a waste. Master artist Clyde Aspavig said when he comes out to paint, he's trying to paint air and light. And he's very successful at it. If you look at his work, it is just unbelievable. And you can tell that when he, you know, he's painting from experience. He's been out here in these areas. And that's just comes from painting from life. Okay, everything's pretty well blocked in. Gonna just hit it with the palette knife a little bit. The light is really changing on these mountains. It moves fast, as I knew it would. I wish I got here a little bit sooner, but I was painting in a different spot, and that's kind of a dilemma that I get, you know, in an area I've never been at before. I'll drive into it and I'll see something that I think is really great. There might be something even better down the road a bit, and I'm always like, do I stop and paint this, or do I drive on down and see if there's anything better? I almost stopped further back and did a scene that would have been nice, but not this nice. Now for the snow, mixing a little bit of a yellow ochre. And just a touch of the Portland Gray Warm, just to push it back a bit. more bugs landing on me. Really struggling with this area up here because it's actually being sunlight's hitting it, but it's so far away too that I'm struggling between showing the depth of it, and then it does transition into a subtle shadow area here. I'm just going to leave it like that for now. I got all these little bugs landing on me. I'm trying to fling them away, but the biting ones, I just got to get rid of them. Something I want to do from a drawing perspective that I think is very important. Need to mix a little more sky color. Normally, I don't fuss with drawing this much, but this I feel is important. There, this mountain kind of cuts over like that, and I like showing the how it comes forward like this. That's important to me. So since it's important to me, it's going in. this area is going to require quite a bit of simplification. There's a lot of sunlight hitting it. And while I want to be truthful to it as much as I can, I also want this to look good. All this stuff gets somewhat warmer as we move over, but as we move this way, I have to make sure I look in the right place too, though, because there's a temptation where I can see a lot more than what I have in my painting. at this point, I'm really just putting tones down and kind of reacting to them. These tones back there are so ambiguous. So you just really are asking yourself, and you put it down, and you know, is it too light, too dark, too warm, too cool? That's all you can do at this point. You can't get it perfectly exact. It's just not going to happen. And you don't have to, and you don't want to. It's all about the relationships. And I'm just jumping back and forth all over the place. I try not to zero in too much on one area, because if I do, start to see all kinds of crazy stuff, and then I don't relate it with the whole anymore. And everything you put down should serve the purpose of the whole. It should fit in with the entire keen of what you have here. Nothing should stand out, you know, be on its own. And not look like it's actually part of the scene. I think these get a little too dark. I want them to be darker than what's back here. But I may have overdone it. So this is looking further away than this, because it's not really following the aerial perspective rules. So I need to either darken this a little bit, warm it up, or cool that. Now, there's a bit of an anomaly here in that these are trees essentially being illuminated by sunlight, even though this is a little further away than this here. It's going to be a little warmer back there because of the green. The big question I have to ask myself is, do I want to leave it like that? There's actually some business going on in here. I don't have this drawn exactly how it is, but that's all right. Okay, I want to visit these clouds a little bit. That's a bit too dark. Even though that's on the tape, that'll bug me having those dark valleys there. okay, I have to soon end this. This light is moving so much, and I'm going to keep chasing it, and I'll never be happy with this thing. I've often joked that I need a painting caddy. I think I need somebody to wrap me over the head and tell me when to stop too. Especially in these mountain scenes, because I love mountains and I want so bad to get them right. And I'm not around mountains like this very often. I wish I was, but okay, so in the foreground there is a big rock. Couple big rocks, and I think I'm going to put one in. Just for the sake of interest. Put one right there too. So going in with these powerful greens in the foreground, that's going to help push everything back and give more depth and distance to all the trees back here, or all the mountains back there. These trees are mostly backlit, but I'm going to have them be dominant on one side as far as lighting is concerned. We don't want these highlights to get too light. It is so glorious being out here. It's a slight breeze, temperature is almost perfect. And I want to thank you for watching, for sticking with me this long. I usually talk a lot more in my videos. If you check out my other videos, you will see that, hear that, I should say. But when I'm on a very challenging subject that I haven't painted, I tend to keep my mouth shut. You might enjoy that anyway, who knows? I know. Some people like commentary, but it's nice to just watch somebody paint and hear the sounds of nature. Okay, I think we'll call that a painting. Thanks for watching. We'll see you next time.